Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. And today was a very special day for all the Apple fans out there, and it was one of the most awaited thing, which is the Apple MacBook Pro release. Like everyone else, I watched the video and I was pretty excited. I tuned in, and then the very first thing we're going to address today is the notch. There was a Face ID in the iPhones, and there is a reason to have that notch up there, but in the new MacBook Pro 2021 with the notch, it's just for the camera. There's no Face ID, which is frustrating for many, but I would like to see it as a camera improvement. And finally, Apple decided to put a 1080p camera on the MacBook. The new camera module, which is so big, it actually needs an entire notch. Can you believe that? I'm just having a hard time, you know what I mean? Like, the punch cut displays on Samsung, on Xiaomi's for the last 2 years, and Apple, the one of the biggest companies in the world, is trying hard, and their engineering team is not able to come up with another brilliant idea. So at this point, I just feel like Apple is trying to create a generalization here. Regardless of millions of people who are against the whole idea of the notch, Apple notch trademark. Talking about everything old is new, like many people mentioned, the first thing that comes back, which is my favorite, is the MagSafe. The MagSafe was first introduced in 2006, and it was very exciting for many people, and also I was very curious to try it out. But unfortunately, by the time when I decided to buy the Mac in 2018, the MagSafe was already removed. Moving on to the next big feature, the touch bar is no more. So when I bought the MacBook, I specifically bought the touch bar one, even though it was like $300 extra, because I really wanted that touch bar. I was so much into that touch bar, but I never used it. I used it a couple of times. I tried using it, but first thing, it's on the top. When you can easily do most of the functions using the trackpad, why I need to surpass all this key and the trackpad and go on the top and select the options, which is completely useless. So in the last 4 years, I think I maybe used the touch bar for a month. That's it. Anyway, so that's removed now. Another great feature this year is the HDMI port is back. So I've been actually struggling with it because my external monitor, which doesn't support the USB-C because it's a cheap model, so I need to buy a dongle to connect it to the HDMI and then to the USB-C so I can connect it finally to my Mac. Now I don't need to do that if I have the latest Mac. I wonder how many of you find the HDMI useful feature, because there's AirPlay these days. I don't actually know how much it matters in this time. There's a SD card slot, it's not micro SD, in the new MacBook Pro, which is gonna be a great thing. One of the reasons I wanted to make this video is that I really wanted to upgrade my Mac. I've been using my MacBook Pro, it's been 4 years, it's 2018 model. It was actually getting slow, especially when I edit my 4K footages, so which is expected on a 4-year-old machine where it's not supposed to edit 4K videos, and I'm pushing it through. Once I started observing that my MacBook is getting slower, what I did is that I did a Google search and I found this amazing software called CleanMyMac X, and it actually helped me a lot. It finds a lot of junk files, cache, and also deletes so many unwanted files, which actually help you free up some space. And also it clears the RAM, it gives you warning when the RAM is overflowing. It's an incredible tool. So you can actually check out that. I'll put a link in the description. Mine is not the M1 chip, it is the Intel chip. So the M1 MacBooks are already faster compared to the Intel chip, because my friend bought like a couple of months ago the new M1 chip, and it handles the 4K videos much better than the Intel chip. So can you imagine what happens on an M1 Pro and M1 Max chip? Apple is also upping the graphics performance for the M1 Pro and M1 Max, which comes with 16 and 32 graphics core. So definitely it's a great upgrade for me if I'm considering it. If you're on M1, I don't see the point of upgrading it unless you want it even smoother and high CPU usage tasks, like rendering a 4K video or something like that, or crunching some data, especially web developers and app developers, they could actually use some extra cores of that CPU and also the graphic performance. The real question, does it actually worth upgrading? The pricing is insane. So if you're a normal university student, you're not a that pro person, you just need to have a laptop, then M1 is the laptop you should go for. There's no need to upgrade it. But if you are looking for some 4K editing and also more smoother graphics, and who's going to have a lot of traveling going on and editing on the go with the support for MagSafe, also the micro SD card is going to help you quickly swap out the videos that you made. Or for them, the new MacBook is good because we can attend the meetings on the go with a better camera and noise cancellation, especially with three microphones with air beaming technology and stuff. That's my take on it. But I was very frustrated this morning, so you guys can also share some thoughts about this on the comments down below. And please do check out the CleanMyMac X product that I've been using. It's pretty cool, and even the free version does the magic, so you guys can check it out. And it's pretty futuristic looking. I gotta say, this is one of the best softwares that I ever seen on a Mac. All right, so I'll see you guys with another video. Thanks for watching today. I'll see you all later. Bye.